So that brings up the question of red maples. Do you tap them? Yes, I do. We don't have a lot, of red maples in our woods, but when they're accessible, I tap them.
I think that's the most common maple tree in the United States.
I believe it is the most common tree in the United States. I'm almost sure of that.
Fact check that, right?
No, you don't have to. I said it. It's true.
Okay.
No, the red maple
is the most common tree is the red maple.
Yeah, I'm not gonna steer you wrong
you
on that.
Here.
Yeah. You heard it right here. Anything else you hear is wrong.
And it makes great maple syrup.
It makes great maple syrup. Where we used to tap trees, where we used to make syrup up in the UP of Michigan, we had a lot of red maples.
So the downside, if you were to pick one out, would just be that they bud sooner?
They bud sooner. They, in my experience, the sap runs just as well as a sugar maple. And I'm starting to get a little bit warm now. So the sap runs just as well as sugar maple. The sugar content is indistinguishable in terms of the amount of sugar it has. It's just as good. The season ends sooner on them. So you guys that tap at the end of January here in central Wisconsin, you just don't worry about it. All your taps are going to be dried up before you have to worry about that. But if you tap during maple season, the red maples can quit early. They bud early too, but a lot of people look at a red maple. This one's the crown is too high up to really see, but I see buds on red maples, like not swollen buds, but like they're starting to appear already in the fall, last fall. But man, they make good syrup. I don't hesitate to tap them. I like them.
Well, this is what it boils down to.
That's what it boils down to.